Karan, we can't hear you. Karan, I think you're mute. Cool. So let's start, guys. We have almost 100 attendees right now. Okay, so good morning, everyone. I'm Karan Vagh. Thank you for joining us today. I hope you guys are doing well. Also, in today's session, I, along with my team, will give you a brief introduction about what is DSE-MESCO, then why should you join us, and what will you guys learn here, what are the activities you can participate in. So yeah, let's start right into it. Gaurav, next slide, please. Okay, so let's start with what is Developer Students Club. So as you can see, Developer Students Club is a university based community program which is powered by Google Developers. So you guys are from undergraduate or graduate programs and you guys have interest in growing as a developer, you guys are welcomed over here. Also, students who have want to learn knowledge in peer to peer learning and they want to build solutions for local businesses, they want to grow as a developer, they are welcomed here. But you might not be having a actual idea about what is Developer Students Club. So I would like to give you a video. I'll show you guys a video and you will get some brief introduction about it.
Hi, I'm Erica.
And I'm Komal. We're from Google Developers and here to tell you about Developer Student Clubs.
Developer student clubs train thousands of student developers globally and work with their communities to solve real-life problems.
I'm sure you're curious how it works. Google selects amazing students from across the globe once a year to be a developer student club lead and start a club on their campus. These clubs host workshops to help students learn about Google technologies.
And they work with local businesses, startup, NGOs, even their universities to build real solutions for real problems.
These leads believe knowledge is power and the technology can do extraordinary things for the world.
They take on the responsibility to help students learn and empower these students to solve real problems around them.
Through this experience, they not only bridge the gap between theory and practice for students, but leave a legacy of impact.
Join us in building a global community for students.
So I guess by now you must be understanding what is DSC. It's basically powered by Google and we start a club in the campus. But to start a club, I'm the lead and I need some good community so that we can reach you. So I present myself. You will be like, who is this guy? So I would like to introduce myself, guys. I'm Karan Vagh. I'm DSC lead for MESCO. So I love exploring new field in technologies and mainly I'm into machine learning. Also, I love contributing towards open source. I love GitHub. I contribute many projects to it. Also, I love Android development and web development. Last year I was nominated to apply for DSC lead. So this year I applied with the guidance of RX core Parag and I got selected for it. So DSC lead is a typical developers every year and there are around only 1,000 leads, 1,000 developer students club in the world. And in India, we are around having this year 200 and our college is one of it. So it's a very prestigious thing for us. So this is me, Karan Vagh. This was my introduction. I would like to introduce my team to you guys. So we have Varun Irani, Prem Kulkarni and Pratik Temkar. These guys are technical cores and they are having amazing knowledge in the field of technical stuff. They will be guiding you with all the fields like Flutter, app development, web development, anything you want, even in machine learning, you can reach them, guys. Also, for publicity core, we have Sakshi Chaudhary and Tani Raina. They are very good with management skills. As well as we have to design posters to reach out to you guys. We have Lockick and Kef. Those are the design cores. And along with me, I have a finance course to bring sponsorship. Sponsorship plays an important role. So we have Gaurav Varma and Dhruvil Shah, who are the finance core for us. So moving to next session, I would like to call upon Gaurav Verma.
Hello everyone, my name is Gaurav Verma, and as Karan said, I am the finance core this year for DSC. So just a minute. So what will you learn over here at DSC? So DSC, as Karan said, it is Developer Student Club by Google developers. So what are the things you'll be learning this year? So no one is perfect in everything, right? Hence, to complete a given task, collaboration is necessary. So the more you collaborate with your peers, the more knowledge you'll attain and you'll learn to work in a team. We have provided you with this platform to exchange ideas with like-minded people and build a community. We have mentors available with us all the time. Apart from technical skills, you will learn to push yourself and you'll be given an opportunity to network with industry experts. As a community, we provide you a platform to contribute to society, to solve any local problems. At the end of every year, Google Developers organizes something called a solution challenge, where you can make an application which can solve any local problem. Last year, we were placed 20th at the global level in the solution challenge. And yes, of course, host awesome events like this. You will be involved with content writing, management, poster design, getting sponsorships. Even if you're not good in technologies, you can still contribute to the club in many different ways. And now, so we have domains which we'll be focusing on this year. So the domains include AI/ML, which is artificial intelligence and machine learning, full stack web development. As we know, websites, everyone is using websites. So we'll be using full stack web development, mobile app development, UI UX, core programming, competitive programming for your future needs to get placed into any companies, interview preparation, and of course the Google Cloud. So to tell you more about full stack development, I would like to call Prem.
Hello everyone, am I audible? Gaurav, am I audible?
Yes.
So hello everyone, my name is Prem Kulkarni. I'm from TECOM second shift. I'm one of the technical course here at DSC Moscow. So I'm going to talk about web development as a whole, and let's start with front end. So front end development is a skill that converts data into user interface by using languages and front end technologies like React, Vue.js, Angular, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, etc. They work towards improving the UI and UX, that is user interface and user experience, so that the user can interact with the website and also have a better experience. In DSC Moscow, some of the jobs that the front end developers do are developing designs and pages for our events. We also dedicate different training sessions for you guys so that to teach you guys the different aspects of the front end development. And also building dynamic projects. For instance, we here at DSC Moscow have designed and developed our own website that showcases all the events that we have held, all the projects that you guys submit, all the videos, and all the information about the core members as well. So you can check that out later. So next slide, Gaurav. Backend. So moving forward to one of my favorite parts, web development backend. So what a backend engineer does is it is the skill that powers the web, right? It includes handling the databases, all the APIs, all the user data, and powering the web app itself. Some of the jobs that the backend developer do in DSC Moscow are maintaining the club's website. For instance, we update the database every time an event is held, and we update the database with all the events information, everything, so that the website can display all the recently held events, all the upcoming events, etc. We also provide backend support to all the applications and live projects. We also participate in training sessions with you guys, to motivate you and also help you learn all the different things that is to be learned regarding backend development. And last but not the least, guys, your hard work needs to be appreciated. So we provide a platform to host and showcase some of the best projects developed by you guys on our website. So I hope you guys will be looking forward to that. And I would like to call Varun Irani next to explain something about app development. Thank you.
Hello everyone, Varun Irani here. I am one of the technical cores here at DSC Moscow. So let us talk about app development. So there are a very few applications now out there that have not been put onto their phones. Like, you know, there's no mobile app version of it. There are very few applications who don't do mobile apps nowadays. So everything nowadays can be done with just that small little thing that is in your pocket. And so we as a DSC can bring experts to talk about app development. And also we can conduct hands-on sessions to help you get started. So earlier this year, we conducted something called Flutter Interact Extended. And so that showcased Google's new technology for mobile, web, and desktop development using the language Dart. And so adding mobile development to your skills will definitely increase the chances of landing a good placement in a company. And of course, for the solution challenge, you have to develop an application. So using something like Flutter will be really, really quick and really easy. So we'll teach you that, not to worry about that. Next slide, please. All right, so something about the cloud. So a cloud is just another fancy word of saying a really, and I mean really powerful machine, which you can use for a certain amount of credits. So you learn about GCP, Azure, AWS, and you learn about hosting your own application using the Google Cloud's App Engine. You can create virtual machines. You can test out some APIs. You can learn about machine learning and a little bit data science as well. And the best part about this is that you get complimentary credits from us and for Quick Labs. So Quick Labs is just a Google's hands-on lab to teach you about the cloud and how it works and what things you can do. Next slide, please. All right, competitive programming. So this world is definitely now a bit more competitive nowadays because technology is just available everywhere and it's getting much better and better. So anyone can just pick up a machine and just start coding. But to be the one who is the star in your solar system, you definitely have to be more competitive. And for that, we will definitely encourage you to start going to HackerRank, going to CodeChef, going to HackerEarth, and building up your base and foundation of development, getting better thoughts, better logic for a certain program that you're going to write. And so the interviewers out there definitely expect you to give a solution that is more efficient, more optimum, and as short, as simple as possible, not some junk big code. Okay, so they don't expect that. So competitive programming is definitely going to be one of the aspects that we'll focus on this year. All right. And next for machine learning and AI, I will definitely bring on Laukik Chavan. Go ahead, Laukik.
Thank you, Varun. Hi guys, I am Laukik Chavan. I am from TCOM2 and I am from Design Core. Everybody here are familiar with terms like machine learning, artificial intelligence, deep learning, etc., etc. But how many of you know how to program a self-learning chatbot that is sorta like Google Assistant, but little simpler? Not many, right? Here, we can help you to teach you basic of ML and AI, how to design a chatbot, how to implement it, how can we can arrange a session on Python programming language, which is right now most loved language to develop an AI ML model. And how cool is it to create a program that mimics behavior of a neuron in your brain? There is a lot of things out there about ML and AI, and we in DSE want you to learn and to grow with us in ML and AI. These fields of technology are very new, and because of it, they are rapidly growing. Next. In the DSE, not everything is related to coding and technical. Here we also require some artistic minds, because you see, a programmer can develop an app which can do multiple things at the same time. But if nobody understands how to use it, it's worthless. At that point comes UX and UI team, or in our case, Design Core. In Design Core, we use softwares like Adobe Illustrator, Photoshop, and for open source lover like me, GIMP and Inkscape. To wireframe the app, website, or any application, to use that as a prototype, to design a poster, because if you send just a text message to everybody, it's not that attractive. And even if your content is unique and good, nobody will come to attend your session. Designers are crucial for any organization because only their work will be seen by others and attract normal and non-techie people. The designing team's job is not just designing. I mean, yeah, that is their main job, but they also have to collaborate with other DSE core members and own core members. So they also require some level of communication skills to understand what the members want and what you can deliver. That is a brief intro to UX and UI and graphic design. Next.
Hello, I am Tanya Rena, the Public Relations Core. Public relations is the practice of managing the release and spread of information between the club and the public. Public relations helps you enhance your communication and interpersonal skills. It will also help you take initiative, plan effectively, and manage events and people. You will learn how to reach out to people for events and collaborations, how to spread awareness. There will also be opportunities to expand your connections and interact with members within the club. You can manage proceedings and documentation, draft out notices and invitations for speakers and other authorities, and will gain experience in writing articles on Medium and other blog websites. Next, Sakshi will talk about the benefits of being a member.
Hello, I'm Sakshi Chaudhary and I'm Public Relations Core at the DSE MESCO. So by now you might be well aware with what is DSE, how DSE functions, what technologies are included in the technical, what designing really is, and many much more things. So the next obvious question is like, why should I join DSE? Or what are the benefits of becoming a DSE member? So I am here to explain you the benefits you'll be getting by being a DSE member. The very first benefit is that you get an opportunity to improve your skills. The club organizes events from time to time, and every time you learn some new technologies. Next, your efforts get a very good recognition. Once you become a member of the club, you can upload your projects, blogs, stories on our social handles and website for a better reach. Another major benefit is that you get free access to certain resources provided by Google developers. Example was a quick labs one given by Varun. Next slide, please. Okay, so the next is, a very promising benefit, a really strong point in your resume, a member of Google Developers Club. Doesn't it sound like a perfect headline for your LinkedIn profile? Apart from this, as it is a club, you get to connect with peers having similar interests. Who knows, you might have just found your project partner. Work together and build awesome projects, and we will showcase it. Last but not the least, you learn the latest industry relevant skills. One more key point which I would like to address is that this year DSA is not only for computer undergraduates, but also it is extended to the mechanical and ENTC departments. So now even the mech and ENTC guys will learn the new trends in technology. So as there are many people here to manage everything and make learning fun, we have divided you all into teams. I would now like Kev to take over.
Thank you, Sakshi. I'm Kev. I'm the design core for DSE MESCO. And like Sakshi mentioned, DSE is not exclusive to comp anymore. You don't need to have a hardcore coding background to avail the benefits of DSE. So this year we've decided to include both mechanical and ENTC branches in our club. And we're expecting a large number of people to enroll for this. And to make matters more easier to manage and more interesting to manage, we've decided to divide you people into teams, namely Team Red, Team Blue, Team Green, and Team Yellow, the Google colors. Now, let me explain to you how we have decided to divide the teams. Let's say we have 40 people from mechanical who have registered. Let's say we have 60 from ENTC. We have 80 from comp. So what we'll do first is we'll first divide the 40 into four different parts, and that's 10 each. So each team gets 10 of mechanical. Similarly, each team gets 15 of ENTC and 20 of comp. So everyone has an equal distribution of engineers from the various branches. So matters seem fair, and nobody suspects there to be any biasing towards a particular branch. And next slide, please. So the point of a team is to consider various activities that can be conducted. So we've decided to conduct new events and various tasks on sites like HackerRank and CodeChef to increase your code efficiency, your logical applications, your competitive coding application, etc. We have, of course, inter-team coding competitions. Basically like hackathons. A hackathon is basically where you make your own idea and then you develop it. And if your idea is the best outside, if your idea is the best amongst everyone, you win the competition basically. So that's what a hackathon is. And you won't be doing all of this for nothing. winners do get certificates and goodies from Google itself. So it's a very nice opportunity if you actively take part in the new events, the competition and the tasks we dish out every month. And I think the most important thing that you can take from all this is learning how to work as a team, collaborating with various kinds of engineers, and developing apps which are more oriented towards the society. Thank you. Now Prateek will explain to you how you can communicate with the DSE core members.
Before Prateek, I'll tell you what kind of sessions will you have over here. So session number one would be hands-on workshop. So what will happen over, we'll guide you from the beginning till the end, how to do a certain task such as Quick Labs or Git. That's hands-on workshop. Point number two would be solution challenge. Solution challenge, as we said earlier, it's a platform given us by Google developers so that we can create a local solution within less amount of time. Expert tech talks. We have very good industry experts and mentors with us available at all times, so we can take their insights with us. Explore ML. Explore ML is a collaboration between Google AI team and Developer Student Club, where we curate certain sessions so that people get interested into machine learning. Cloud Study Jams. As we said, Cloud Study Jams is when a group of people get together and they study Google Cloud, and after completing a certain amount of tasks, you can get a swag like this. This is from Google itself. And the next one is bootcamps, coding bootcamps. Over here, we'll teach you a certain technology from the basic till the intermediate level as soon as possible. What type of sessions will we have? Workshop on basic topics for beginners. Not everyone is good at coding, so hence we have workshops on the basics of each topic with us. A workshop on deeper concepts for intermediates. If you know basic topics, we have experts which will help us to get into deeper topics. And project development for everyone. We'll teach you the project development cycle. How should a project be started? So first identification of problem and all those things we'll be teaching you as soon as possible. Next, I'd like to call Prateek to explain how will you guys communicate with us.
Hello, I am Prateek, the technical core here at DSC MESCO. And as we know, a community is a social unit, so we need a lot of interaction between different members of the DSC and also between the members of the DSC and the course. So in these virtual times, it is very difficult to have a one-on-one interaction. So we have tried our best to be on all the platforms available. So we are available on WhatsApp, Slack, email, Discord, or any platform, you know. So members are also requested to create their Discord accounts and join the DSC MESCO Discord server, as it is the preferred medium for our community. And our motto is also to discuss, learn, and create together. So moving on, I'll just show you the Discord server that we'll be using. So yeah, this is the Discord server that we'll be using as a community, because it is the closest we can be for any community. So these are different information channels in which all the announcement, event info, social feed, etc. will be given. And there are also member channels in which you can chat with different members on different topics of which you are passionate about. You can also talk about coding. You can sort some bug out. And there are also voice channels in which you can talk to members, or you can just switch on your camera. You can have a meeting kind of, and you can also share screen in these voice channels. There are community channels whose motto is just to chill. So you can just show up here, share memes, find your gaming partners. And there are these community voice channels where you can actually talk about stuff that is not about academics. And at last, there are the music channels where you can just listen to music. So yeah, that is all. And now I would like to call Karan for explaining how to subscribe to the DSC newsletter.
Yeah, so as Prateek explained, you guys can join the Discord server. We'll add you guys. We'll be circulating all the Google Forms later. So yeah, the main thing is how will you receive newsletters and updates? So we are planning to update it on your membership channel. We are having a community forum. You can take that. Yeah, so we are having a community channel in which you, I'll share the link. You guys can directly join in. You can click the join in button. You guys can get all the newsletters, monthly updates, what all the things we do and all. Also, Discord. Guys, please join Discord. It's an amazing thing. It's an amazing platform you can interact on. Also, yeah, the main thing is we'll be circulating the things. And hope you guys will be able to join this year. And I would like to call upon Parag to explain all the things we did last year and all.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, Parag.
Yes, Parag.
So hi, hello everyone. It's good to see so many people join in today, like the Sunday morning, and this has been a huge response. And thank you guys for joining in. So I'll talk about myself. Hi everyone, I am Parag Gorpade. I am the ex-DSC lead for DSC MESCO. And I'll talk about the things that we did in the previous years, which you can expect the similar kind of events, but in a much better planned way. So I'll talk about the things which you can see on your screen. So we have this first photo wherein we organized a Flutter Interact event. So what is Flutter Interact? Flutter Interact event is basically carried out in the United States, and then they live stream their old recordings in India, so that you can learn about the new technologies and new advancements that have been done in Flutter and all the mobile technology. So the one unique thing about this is that Flutter Interact was conducted by our DSC MESCO member, Varun Irani, and mentor, Faizan Akhtar. So that's what I want to tell you, that the club isn't about just the cores and the higher members, higher executive group. It's about you guys. You are the members that, you know, make a club, and it's your responsibility to be open, and you should be very excited to take part in other events and as well. So we have this a list of events that we carried out last year, like the GCP crash course. You must have known about it. You can see it in the second picture, wherein we had the DSC lead for India, who came in and, you know, he gave us a small speech about how the communities work and why the club is, you know, so famous in this times. And basically what GCP crash course is, like, you will get to learn a lot of cloud technologies, like hosting a website, probably you deploying a machine learning model, or all the mobile technologies that you can do on cloud and everything. So we had some Explore ML events as well, wherein we discussed how machine learning is employed in today's world, how you can be a part of it, how you can learn it in a much organized way. And in the end, we had some web development and machine learning sessions, which, you know, enabled you to learn about web technologies like React, and then HTML, JavaScript, CSS, everything. So I'll talk about the importance of communities, how communities impact your life, how they help you shape your future, and how you can benefit from it. So communities is all about teamwork. It's not a competition. It's about teamwork, how you interact with others, how you learn to socialize, how you interact with people, how you collaborate, and then participate in events in a much, you know, a much friendly way, not in a competitive way. So There will be a series of hackathons that will be conducted this year. There are many opportunities that DSC provides you, essentially, and you should know how to contribute and take part in those activities. It's not just necessary to be taking part in two events. You can even host an event. You can talk to Karan or any of the core team members, and they'll organize the event for you if it fits in their roster of list of events, right? So hi, I'll talk about how DSC helped me personally. So yeah, I was an introvert. I couldn't imagine coming out and speaking in front of this number of people, even on an online event, right? So that kind of confidence that DSC gives you, and it basically takes you out of your comfort zone, and you are able to pursue all kinds of things that you never thought it would be possible for you to do, right? So yeah. That's the main thing I think DSE helped me, and of course it helped me get an internship in the fourth year, and probably that is all I wanted to say. And hope you guys make most of the club, and this is for you guys, so whatever you do, it's ultimately going to help you. So don't hesitate to participate ask your friends to come aboard and then form a team, contribute into some open source project, create a project that helps the community, and in the end also participate in the solution challenge. I think that's what I wanted to tell you. Hope you guys enjoy the next year of DSE.
Thank you, Parag, for sharing your insight. So just to tell you guys, this club was introduced in our college last year. Also, since last year, we have achieved many remarkable benchmarks. You can follow us on all the social media links we have given here. As you can see, we are on LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram. We are forming a WhatsApp group soon and a Discord server. So make sure you follow us, stay tuned. We'll be updating there also. We are giving a monthly opportunity to feature your projects. So yeah, this is a great platform. We will showcase you and your talent will get recognized. Next slide, please. Yeah, so get in touch with us. You can connect to us at this website. We will be featuring all your projects over the project section over here. This website was developed by my technical team. Everyone played an important part over here because everyone get featured, all your projects, all the events we have, all the things you show. So this is featured on the website. You can check out the website at dacmesco.tech. Next slide, Gaurav. Okay, so yeah, before ending up asking you queries for the Q&A round, guys, I want to just tell you one thing, that this club was introduced in our college since last year, and we have achieved a remarkable benchmark since last year. We have reached around 10,000 people in more than 5 countries, and we have around 5 plus industrial expert mentors so that they can guide you guys anytime. You just have to ask us which session you want and we will just host a session for you. Also, we have more than 400 people who attended the Explore ML and the GCP crash course. More than that, they got the Google hoodies and everything. You get participant certificates for all the events you join in. And I hope you guys will be joining this year too. So if you have any queries, just shoot out. We have a Q&A session right now. Okay, so we'll be sharing the Discord link here. You can join us.
We have a question on how to join the club. So you can join the Discord link and the community page, and click on the join button on the community page, and that will help you join the club. Where is the community page? Over here. If you go on this site, my friend will put it in the chats, and click the join button here. You will get into the community and join the Discord also, and we'll be sharing a form also for you to fill up. That's how you can join the club. Thank you, Anonymous.
Guys, you can ask all your queries.
Someone is asking, does it cost money, Karan?
No, dude, it's actually totally free. It's totally free. You don't have to pay any cost over here. We have sponsors for us. We have our finance team working for the sponsors. So you don't need to pay anything. You just have to join in, learn the technology, because we think that technology should be available to everyone. You guys should get some insight. So yeah, it's totally free of cost.
Someone is asking what is section criteria, or anyone is in the for the group.
Okay, so selection criteria, that will depend. Selection criteria is that everyone is welcome this year. But we have to segregate you guys depending on your branches. So once upon all the submissions you get, we'll just look about all the total number of comp people, MEC people and ENTC people, and then we'll do it accordingly. Yeah, how to become a member, I'll be circulating the Google form later after this session.
Someone is asking, can you please share your experience about competitive coding?
So we have amazing mentors in the field of competitive coding. We have Sudesh Pawar as our competitive mentor, and we will be having industry experts. We'll have people coming from various competitive fields to give lectures.
How to become a member?
We will be sharing the Google form soon. You can join the Discord member and join in the membership on this link. Click on this link.
Someone is asking, how are we going to learn coding?
Maybe Varun, you can tell us more about it.
Yeah. So we'll be hosting sessions mostly on Microsoft Teams here. And every time we're going to ask you to come and join, we're going to start from the basics again. There's one slide particular that says we'll start from the basics and then go intermediate and advanced. So we will just easily, like, we will share a certain link where you can start messing around with code and you can learn something new from us here. There are always coding sandboxes online, so you can always test out stuff.
We have a question called, when will the activities resume? So we have our first event planned within a week. It will be about UI and UX, and we are having many events lined up for you guys so that you can learn with us.
Can you send link?
Someone is asking, what will be the role of ENTC student in the group?
Okay, so I would like to address this question. What will be the role of ENTC people? So you guys must be having something about coding for Arduino and all stuff. But apart from that, we are teaching you guys from basics, like from UI design, from competitive coding. So you will be attending various sessions with that. It's very beneficial. Like, apart from ENTC, you will be learning for coding. So it will be a great thing. And also we are having hackathons. So you guys can collaborate. So ENTC people, some people from comp and other people from MEC, you guys can collaborate, share your ideas, and you can just win it. Like, we have cash prize lined up for you guys. So it's a very cool thing. Can't we create a team on MS Teams? So yeah, we are planning to do that, but that's not a feasible thing for us right now, because Discord is the only medium which is used by many communities. Slack was too professional. We tried using it last year. So I guess we will be having a WhatsApp group and a Discord server as well. So that's a preferred medium for us. With technologies we will be learning. So yeah, new technologies. Okay, then I will tell you guys the new technologies such as machine learning, deep learning. You guys be knowing about deepfakes. So deepfakes is the one, Flutter, then many things like from app development, Kotlin, web development, full stack development, competitive coding. There are many things which are planned for you guys. I guess Varun will tell you more in deep.
Yeah. So we'll be learning from front end to dip, just basically what kind of skills you need from front end to just deployment, everything. So because you should be like multitasking and you should be knowing a lot of things. That's what companies expect nowadays. So not to worry, we'll be here from front end with React, then Flutter, then maybe Angular, JavaScript, all these things for the front end. Back end, we have Node.js, creating Express APIs, connecting your front end with the APIs, then having a particular back end or a database connecting to MongoDB, MySQL Server, lots of things. And most importantly, if you want to host applications, we will also teach you how to host them on different platforms, GCP, AWS, Azure, Heroku, Hostinger, all those website providers, all those things. So that's the kind of technologies that we will teach you. And so these skills will really help you in the future.
Someone is asking, how frequent are DSC sessions?
Yeah, so the mandatory thing is we have to take once a month, but depending on the enthusiasm of the crowd, we will be taking it twice in 2 weeks or maybe twice in a month. So it depends on you guys. If you face anything, we'll be hosting it accordingly.
Parag, this question for you. How does it help in an internship?
Yeah, I'll address that. So yeah, I'll tell you how exactly it helped me. So what we did was we pursued a series of hackathons like Smart India Hackathon and the Google Solution Challenge. So in that, we got to know that just learning about how to code doesn't really help you that well when you are facing a real world situation. There are a number of factors that you know you should consider while developing a product or a solution. So what you learn about that is how to search the relevant things and then how to use them. It's not about just about what you learn in the course, like on Coursera or some extra courses that you do. You also get to learn how to be, you know, flexible and how to mix and match everything and develop a better solution. So when you have this kind of experience, when you face an interviewer or anything, anyone, it doesn't matter who the interviewer is, you can be very confident about your project because you know in depth about how the project works, how the basically what I did was I was mostly working on machine learning and the cloud related stuff. So interviewer used to ask me like, what is this regularization algorithm? Explain it to me. How the backpropagation algorithm works. So these are the basic things which you will know because you already have worked on much more complex things. So basically, it gives you confidence and a wide knowledge of that a particular area. So even if you pursue a web development or anything, you can do much better with that. And also, I'd like to tell you about the Google's hashcode competition. Like the people who are interested in pursuing the competitive coding and everything, you can participate in hashcode, which will be organized in February, I guess, next year. So yeah, and one more thing is that the DSC events are long. Like they don't go live for a day and then they just disappear. They are long. They tend to expand to up to 4 weeks, 3 weeks. So it's not like you'll have just one event in a month. You'll have an event which will extend to 2 to 3 weeks, which will help you get in-depth knowledge about that subject and you'll get to participate and create some awesome projects.
Yeah. Okay, so we have next question. Will you teach us from scratch? Obviously, dude, like not everyone is having knowledge about all things. So we will be starting from scratch. And by the end of this year, I'm surely confident that you will be having some great knowledge in some fields. Like you will be able to decide your domains in which you have to do things. So yeah, we will be starting from scratch. No need to worry about it. We'll be hosting many events according to it.
Karan, that's not enough. Lucky. I want to take one question. Not anyone can afford Adobe software. So how will everyone practice on design and stuff? I never use Adobe software. I use open source software, which are free, GIMP and Inkscape. They are lacking in some functionalities from Adobe and Adobe software. But if you know how to use them, you can do whatever you want. Okay, they are free.
Yeah.
So you no need of Adobe software.
And if you really want to work with Adobe software and just want to try out prototypes and some basic designs, then you can go for Adobe XD. It's completely free. Actually, the homepage that you saw in the slides was first designed in Adobe XD, and then we implemented that in React. Yeah.
There's one question.
Kaurav, you are on mute.
If some students have a backlog, then is the student welcome in a club?
Everyone is welcome in the club. Yeah, there is anyone. No restrictions to anyone. Whoever has the urge or the curiosity to learn, they are welcome over.
Yeah, totally.
Okay, there's one more question. Can you tell us more about how to use competitive platform to get nice coding knowledge, which can help us in placements? So yeah, that will be told to you during the competitive coding sessions. It's not like that we are having and hosting a session right now. So we are just giving an info session about what DAC things we are doing. So that's another stuff. How DAC was introduced in our college? So yeah, DAC last year was introduced by Parag Horpade. He was the lead last year. So every year what happens is there are forms rolled out by Google to start the club at their college. And there are many interview rounds. There are forms and all. They take our interviews and they select one as a lead. So that's how we started our DAC.
There's another question. The thing is we have to register and join the Discord and we are in, right? So yeah, if you have joined the community page and you've joined the Discord, then you become the member.
Yeah.
Any plans related to cybersecurity? Yeah, dude, we are looking for the mentors who are good in cybersecurity. So don't worry about that. You will be having cybersecurity things too.
It'll like depend on people. If there are many people based on like who want cybersecurity, we can give it to you.
Yeah. Okay. Is there any kind of pre-practice that we have to do before joining this club? No. Basically, you should
even if you know a little bit of coding, that is
that's just fine. You can
join.
If you don't know coding, that is also fine.
We have sessions for beginners, intermediate and advanced students, so don't worry.
Yeah, don't worry about it. We'll teach you guys. What is the role of design core? Yeah, you guys can
tell. Logic.
Design core basically design karta hai, website design karta hai, graph, jo tumne poster dekha info session ka, wo design karta hai. और हम सर्कुलेट करते हैं हम बाकी जो बाकी कोर मेंबर से बात करते हैं कोलैबोरेट करते हैं क्या करना है और वैसे वैसे बनाते हैं बस
दे आर आल्सो मोस्टली कोलैबोरेटिंग विद द डेवलपर्स सो दे ऑलवेज इफ दे हैव अ सर्टेन चेंज टू द यूएक्स सम काइंड ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस चेंज देन दे ऑलवेज लेट अस नो एंड वी ऑलवेज कीप मेकिंग गुड चेंजेस टू द वेबसाइट और एनीथिंग एनी प्रोजेक्ट सो बिकमिंग अ डिजाइन पर्सन इज आल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट नाउ सो नॉट जस्ट कोडिंग
वैसे अभी के लिए तो डिजाइन को उतना ही ये एनुअल सैलरी है जितना एक प्रोग्रामर को है सो डिजाइनिंग आल्सो मस्ट
यस यस
ओके सो वी हैव नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन विल देयर बी एनी रोल ऑफ मैक पीपल इन इट साक्षी यू कैन गिव इट अ शॉट साक्षी
Mac people can, as you all know, like Mac people are more into designing. So you all can just start with the design team and gradually you all can learn the technical coding. Mac people, you all have, you all know how to design and all, but when you all come to coding, it's like you get entire knowledge of designing along with coding. So it is very good. And also the club is going to take events, the coding from the basics. So it's very good for you all to start. That's all.
And I think if I'm not wrong, mechanical students also have MATLAB in one there of their semesters.
Yeah, MATLAB, yes. There was a question, so, what is the role of CAF, if CAF wants to address that?
Well, I'm a design coder. I design.
वैसे सब poster CAF ने design किया?
Yeah, my role is to design posters, the videos, the whatever gets posted on the social media. My role is to, like Lokik said, I had some role to play in designing the website, the official dac.techmas website. Yeah, so.
Yeah.
Varun was saying something. Sorry to cut him out.
No. I was agreeing to Kafi as you.
एक और make के people के लिए कि सुंदर पिचाई मेटलर्जी में बीटेक डिग्री है उसकी सो ऐसा नहीं है कि सब कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग सीखे हुए ही बैठे हैं सीईओ कंप्यूटर आईटी सॉफ्टवेयर कंपनी के
कैन यू गिव अस अ टाइम स्पैन लाइक हाउ मच मिनिमम स्किल विल बी रिक्वायर्ड टू लर्न अ पर्टिकुलर स्किल हितेश राम Sorry, I cannot pronounce his surname. So can anyone answer the question?
Yeah, for example, for me, when I was learning all the front-end technologies like React and all, I started with JavaScript, right, with the basics. So that took me around 2 or 3 months to completely familiarize with all the syntaxes and how React works and everything. So if you give, it's up to you how much you give the time to it, right? So if you give more time to it, you can learn it very easily, very fast.
I want to add something. Ki first language ko time lagega, means usko 2 months, yeah. 3 months lagega. But after that, you will learn any language in 1 month or 2 or 3 weeks. Pehli language sabki hard jati aur sabko time lagta sikhne ko.
सबसे मेन ऊप्स के कंसेप्ट स्ट्रांग होने चाहिए बस, और कुछ है?
या सेकंड ईयर में होगा कंप्यूटर लोगों को ऊप्स.
वी हैव अ क्वेश्चन कॉल्ड डज डीएससी हैव मेंबर ऑफ मैकेनिकल और ईएनटीसी. टिल लास्ट ईयर वी डिडंट, बट दिस ईयर वी हैव डिसाइडेड टू इंक्लूड देम आल्सो. मैकेनिकल एंड ईएनटीसी, दे कैन आल्सो रजिस्टर एंड लर्न विद अस. सो द क्लब इज ऑलराउंडर. यस, इट्स काइंड ऑफ इट विल मोल्ड यू इन एवरीथिंग.
Any plans related to XR?
I think he wanted to say HR. I don't know.
No. MR would Faizan like to address that?
Yeah, Faizan, you can address this thing.
Okay, so was the question about the workshops regarding XR?
Yes, at DSC.
Okay, so at my level of expertise is was in mixed reality, and now in COVID I have expanded my skill base to augmented reality too. So yeah, I will be a pass out, but I always love giving back to the community and taking sessions. So Karan and I was having a talk yesterday, so yeah, we agreed that we'll have some sessions on augmented reality too. So if you are interested, just stay tuned on the social media of DSC MESCO. We'll soon have a session on that too.
Okay, so one more thing I would like to add is you guys can have research sessions as well. Like last year, some people, those who are interested in publishing research paper, so we included them in publishing the research papers too. And having a research paper before going to placements is like a big deal. So yeah, last year, Lockcake and all, they just participated in publishing a research paper. So I guess Lockcake can share his experience regarding it.
या वो अच्छा था. हमने सीखा कि कैसे मीन्स तो रिसर्च पेपर में कैसे मीन्स कौन सा टॉपिक लेना चाहिए, उसको कैसे देखना चाहिए, कि उसके पॉइंट्स कैसे निकालने चाहिए, वो सब अच्छे से था. और सबसे ज़्यादा गाइडेंस तो हमें पराग से मिला. इवन पराग के 2-3 पेपर अभी पब्लिश है, सो वो ज़्यादा बता सकता है कि कैसे पब्लिश करे पेपर और कैसे लिखा जाए. Parag?
Hello.
Yes, Parag.
Haan, Parag.
Yeah. Yeah. So writing paper isn't a big deal. Like people make a lot of fuss about it. Like writing paper is something which is a huge achievement. It's not. It's just what you know about the subject. You just have to write it in a much better way, and it should have some kind of innovation related to it. Like it shouldn't just be a copy paste of some previous paper, which you didn't modify and just publish it in IEEE or anything like that. So I can't just tell you about everything about research papers right now. So I'll be taking some sessions if you want in future. It's a in-depth study of how other people essentially do research, and they kind of innovate some new models and new ways to develop a certain machine learning algorithm or something like that. So we'll be having some sessions, and we had Lokek and Rehan who are in third year right now. So they experienced how to write papers, how to research some
particular topic and then, you know, modify it and present it in a much better way. So yeah, we'll have some sessions in future for sure.
Okay, so thank you, Parag. We have next question. How many days will this membership last? So we are starting recruitments today and it will take around a week or so. But the membership to join the chapter on the community page, it's open like throughout the year. You can join the community page over that. So membership is lasting for a whole year, but recruitment is starting from today. Any more questions, guys?
There's one question. What are the basic thing that you need to have before joining the club? There is no basic thing, only the curiosity is needed within you. If you're curious enough, you can learn it. But I don't have a proper knowledge of computer. It's completely fine. It's no problem with it. If you're curious enough, you can learn it.
So I guess that's all the questions, guys. All right, then if you don't have any more questions, any queries, then we can end up this session. Okay. All right then. Thank you guys for joining in. I'll be sharing all the Google Forms and all. You will be soon joining all the Discord servers and all the WhatsApp groups. So stay tuned. Let's make this a grand event too. So thank you guys. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you for attending. And thank you to our senior Faizan for providing us with this platform. And that. One more question we have, just last question. We will be divided into teams. What are we supposed to do after forming teams? So this platform is all about working in collaboration. So you can collaborate with your team to innovate something or to learn from each another. Like everyone doesn't know everything about everything. So you can collaborate if you know about something about machine learning and a person from Mech can teach you about something about how certain material works. So you can just collaborate with each other. You can learn from him and this person can learn with you. So this it's easy for us to manage many people. That's why you're forming clubs. Thank you.
Guys, the best combination of all three departments is robotics. So if you can learn and teach each other, you can have a machine, a robot that just walks on its own. These kind of things are totally possible if you just collaborate together in one team. And that's why we'll have these teams together right now.
So yeah, that's all the questions, I guess.
Will get next updates. We'll get it by today evening, you know, Karan?
Yeah, after the session is over, I'll be sending out all the Google Form things and all.
Thank you.
Thank you Parag, for joining us.
Criteria for a recruitment, everyone is welcomed in. There's no certain criteria.
You just need to show your enthusiasm, stay enthusiastic all over the year, and you just have to participate in all the events. That's it. We don't have any criteria as such because we believe technology is open to all, and that's it. So I guess we can end up the session over here. Thank you for joining, guys.
Thank you for joining, guys.
Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you, everyone.